friends, welcome to pre-market update. Friends, what we saw yesterday, after the RBI governor announced that a repo rate has been kept unchanged at 6.25, market reacted to this news, and it was a sort of unexpected kind of a news. As a result, the market went down from that levels. Sensex closed around 156 points down at ended at 26,237 level, while Nifty was down almost 41 points and closed at 8102 levels. However, the broader market indices also underperformed, and mid-cap and small-cap index were down in the vicinity of 0.2 and 0.5% respectively. What we saw this, as a result of the unchanged policy, rate policy by RBI, rate sensitive sectors like banking, real estate and automobile pair all the intraday gains. If you were to look specifically Bank Nifty closed around almost 1% down yesterday and settled at around 17,953 levels. Prominent losers in the Bank Nifty were Bank of Baroda, ICICI, Axis Bank and Bank of India. In terms of prominent gainers and losers in Sensex yesterday, prominent gainers in Sensex were Adani, HDFC, Hero Motor Corp, Tata Motors and M&M. And top losers which were negatively contributing to the Sensex were Sun Pharma, Axis Bank, TCS, SBI and Tata Steel. Now moving on to friends, global indices update. Yesterday all the three major indices in US ended on a positive note. They were up almost 1%. Now moving on to Asian indices update at this point in time. Asian indices like Nikkei is also trading firm at this point in time. It is up almost 1%. Hang Seng is trading almost 0.86%. In terms of provisional numbers, FIIs were biased to the tune of 194 crore in the cash segments, where DIIs were marginal sellers in cash segment and sellers to the tune of almost 56 crores. SGX at this point in time is trading almost 70 points at 8213 levels, indicating we might open on a positive note considering the strong Asian as well as global cues from US. Now friends, let's have derivative update.
Good morning friends, we'll give you analysis on derivatives. In yesterday's trading session, Nifty did started on a positive note, and soon after the RBI announcement where it didn't cut any interest rates, market reacted on that, and market reacted on the negative note, and thereon we did show on market showing some kind of an selling pressure and have seen some kind of a panic. Due to which Nifty in the last part of the trading session closed with a loss of 0.5%. At 8123.35. Now the open interest terms we did show, and 3% was added in the open interest in this journey of the downfall. In the absolute terms, 5.10 lakh shares were added in the open interest, while cost of carry increased from 3% to 4.5%, and the put call ratio also increased surprisingly by from 1.03 to 1.05. Remember, there is a lot of put writing which has been taking place in the market. Despite the fall which we have seen in yesterday's trading session, market did saw some kind of an addition in the put option, and volatility index cooled off by 1.5%, which is a barometer of the further skepticism among the market participants. And seeing that cool off and the build-up seen in the put option, we do feel the majority of the addition which was been added in the yesterday's trade on the put side has been on the shorter side. And it's put writing which have been taken place in yesterday's trade, due to which we have seen an increase in the put call ratio by 2 basis points. On the options activity, despite market going on the southward direction, we haven't seen much of call writing taking place. In fact, we have been seeing an unwinding in the call option being in 8,300, 8,400 call option. 8,300 being the highest in terms of open interest, I've seen some kind of an unwinding in yesterday's trade by around 5%. While 8,200 call option, I've seen only an addition of around 4% in yesterday's trade. While in put option, we have been seeing a constant addition, 8,000 put option seen an addition of around 1%, and it's highest in terms of open interest with around 77 lakh shares into it, which is quite huge. And 7,900 and 8,100 all is in an addition of around 2-3% in yesterday's trade. There are no securities in bank period for today's trade. On the FIIs front, index futures, they were net biased by 212 odd crores. Index options net biased by 503 crores, while stock futures net sellers by 348 crores and stock options net sellers by 51 crores only. On the market level, FIIs, we have stands at 8155 with a lower range at 8000 and higher range at 8155. SGX Nifty is trading higher, it's up by 70 points in line with positive cues from the international markets which have been getting it. and due to which S650 is higher by 70 points, quoting at 8212, indicating some kind of a gap of opening can be expected in the morning trade. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Now friends, moving on to trading ideas for the day. First trading idea for the day is Cipla Limited. Cipla Limited gets a US FDA approval for anti-severe tablets. This drug is used for hepatitis B virus infection treatment. So this is positive development for Cipla. Action to be taken is long. Cipla stop loss is placed at 562. We'll be targeting level of 585 and 595. The next idea for the day is Coromandel International. Cabinet yesterday approved nutrient-based subsidiaries for phosphatic and potassic fertilizer. Coromandel International is the largest phosphatic fertilizer player in India. So this positive development for Coromandel International. Stop loss is placed at 253.5. We'll be targeting levels of 266 and 272. Next idea for the day is Crompton Greaves. It's a negative idea for the day at current market price of 66. Yesterday, Crompton Greaves share price packed with Paul Spaco for international power business was terminated with mutual consent. So this is a sentimentally negative development as it has now again find buyers for its international power business. Action to be taken is short Crompton Greaves. Stop loss is placed at 67. We'll be targeting levels of 63 and 62. Next idea for the day is Tata Power and Adani. Yesterday, CERC came up with an order which allows Tata Power and Adani to pass on higher costs. So this is positive development for Tata Power and Adani Power. Action to be taken is both ideas are long. Stop loss is for Tata Power is placed at 72.9. We'll be targeting levels of 76.60 and 78. And for Adani Power, stop loss is placed at 31.8. And we'll be targeting levels of 32.75 and 33. Now friends, moving on to news update front, JSW Steel's crude output jumps almost 45% to 12 lakh tons in the month of November. Hindustan Zinc enters solar energy business and it is likely to invest around 630 crore. IOC, BPCL and HPCL signed deal to set up India's biggest oil refinery, around approximately 60 million tons, and it is expected to be set up in Maharashtra. Adani Transmission to buy Reliance Infra's Western asset for a consideration of around 1000 crores. Further on the news update front, 2,335 penalty on telcos for violating KYC norms. ONGC inks pact with Slumberger and Halliburton for two fields. Tata Steel agrees 10-year investment plan for UK. Adani Port signed pact to acquire TM Harbour Services for consideration of 106.27 crores. Today there is going to be an offer for sale on Polaris. Virtusa Consulting is likely to sell around 18.86 lakh shares and floor price is set at around 130 per share. Union Cabinet approves fresh tranche of 1009 crore for Election Commission to buy new electronic voting machines. The purchase will be made through Bharat Electronics and Electronic Corporation of India. Important results today: SAIL, Claris and Finolex Industries. Stocks with positive and negative bias for trading perspective are Kotak Bank, ICICI and JSW Steel are stocks with positive bias. TCS and PFC are stocks with negative bias for the day. Friends, moving on to advisory picks for the day. Picks for the day are Z Limited, Wabatech, Wabak, Granules India, Glenmark and Bajaj Corp. Upside potential of 36, 33, 52, 26 and 33% respectively. Now friends, that's all from advisory desk. Have a wonderful day ahead.